39. Census year 1870. Area 3,603,884. Density 10.70. Census year 1880. Area 3,603,884. Density 13.92. Census year 1890. Area 3,603,884. Density 17.37. The map, Plate 9, Figure 1, shows the density of population in 1890 by states. In southern New England, that is, in Massachusetts, Rhode Island, and Connecticut, the average density of population is as great as in many old European countries. Indeed, in Rhode Island, there are 318 inhabitants to the square mile, in Massachusetts, 278, and in New Jersey, 193. These are all manufacturing states. In the agricultural states of the South, the density ranges up as high as 41 in Virginia and 46 in Kentucky, while in the agricultural states of the Mississippi Valley, we find a density of 68 in the state of Illinois and 61 in Indiana, the average being in the neighborhood of 40 to the square mile. Urban population. Population 3.35. Census year 1800. Population of the United States 5,308,483. Population of cities 210,873. Inhabitants of cities in each 100 of the total population 3.97. Census year 1810. Population of the United States 7,239,881. Population of cities 356,920. Inhabitants of cities in each 100 of the total population 4.93. Census year 1820. Population of the United States 9,633,822. Population of cities 475,135. Inhabitants of cities in each 100 of the total population 4.93. Census year 1830. Population of the United States 12,866,020. Population of cities 864,509. Inhabitants of cities in each 100 of the total population 6.72. Census year 1840. Population of the United States 17,069,453. Population of cities 1,453,994. Inhabitants of cities in each 100 of the total population 8.52. Census year 1850. Population of the United States 23,191,876. Population of cities 2,897,586. Inhabitants of cities in each 100 of the total population 12.49. Census year 1860. Population of the United States 31,443,321. Population of cities, 5,072,256. Inhabitants of cities in each 100 of the total population, 16.13. Census year, 1870. Population of the United States, 38,558,371. Population of cities, 8,071,875. Inhabitants of cities in each 100 of the total population, 20.93. Census year, 1880. Population of the United States, 50,000,000. Today, the number of such cities is 443, and their population 18.25 million, which is 29%, or not very much less than one-third of the entire population. The total population is about 16 times as great as it was 100 years ago, while the urban population is 139 times as great. It has grown 8 times as fast as the total population. This aggregation of the people in the cities is a natural and necessary result of the increasing density of population and of the consequent change in avocations, which was discussed above. It has gone on in this country at a constantly accelerating rate, and the acceleration will probably be in the future even more marked than in the past, as a greater part of our domain reaches and passes in density of population the limit of successful agriculture. Referring to the map, Plate 9, Figure 2, which shows the proportion of urban to total population, it is seen that the urban population of the country is confined almost entirely to the northern states, especially those on the Atlantic border. Indeed, in Massachusetts, Rhode Island, Connecticut, New York, and New Jersey, the urban element is in the majority, and in Rhode Island, more than three-fourths of the people live in its cities. While, on the other hand, the proportion in North Carolina, Mississippi, and Arkansas is but trifling, being less than 5% in each case. Now, if the urban element be subtracted from the total population, there is left what may be broadly characterized as the rural element. Plate 6 shows, by the total length of the bars, the population of the United States at each census, the shaded portion of each bar representing the urban population at each date, while the unshaded portion remaining represents the rural population. This element, which in the early decades increased nearly as rapidly as the total population, has in later years increased much more slowly. Indeed, during the past 10 years, its rate of increase was not much more than half that of the total population. While in several states, there has been an absolute loss of rural population during the past decade, and in many others, the gain has been much less than the average gain of the country. Larger cities, most of which have grown enormously. The numerical increase in our urban population in the past decade is 6,900,000, of which fully 3 million consists of additions to the 28 cities of 100,000 or more inhabitants. Chicago's 500,000 in 1880 has become more than 1 million in 1890. St. Paul, Minneapolis, Omaha, Kansas City, and Denver have doubled or tripled their population. Our greatest city, New York, has apparently enjoyed a comparatively slow growth, but this is only apparent. New York's charter limits include less than one half of the people whose business and social interests lie in that metropolis. The great majority of the people who sleep within an hour's ride of New York's City Hall are, to all intents and purposes, except in name, citizens of New York. But having their residence without its charter limits, they cannot be enumerated as its citizens. A close estimate of the people thus connected with the metropolis places their number at 3,250,000, or second only to London in point of population. This territory, tributary to, but lying outside of the charter limits of New York, has increased in population at a tremendous rate during the past 10 years, while the growth of the city proper has been confined to the upper parts of Manhattan Island and the portion of the city lying upon the mainland. The downtown parts of the city have diminished in population during the past 10 years. This means simply that the ground formerly occupied by residences is being taken for business purposes, that the lower part of Manhattan Island is becoming more and more devoted to business to the exclusion of residents. A similar state of affairs has long existed in London. London consists essentially of a number of municipalities under various names, of which one, the Corporation of London, occupies the center of the city, the neighborhood of St. Paul's. In 1881, this corporation had a population of only 50,000, while in 1891 it had become reduced to 37,000, owing to the extension of business and the consequent reduction in residents. The average size of families has diminished continuously since 1850, when statistics were first obtained, from 5.55 down to 4.93 in 1850.
Never. I only use my phone, nothing. Just my phone and
what
Zoom.
Price point?
And Zoom.
What price point?
Wo auch immer die Maggie mag nicht hier hinterkommen, ne? Die wird ihre Gründe haben. Wenn Hunde irgendwo nicht hinwollen, haben sie ihre Gründe.
Wow.
Irre.
Males ranging from 50.56 up to 51.21 of the total population, as seen in the following table. Census years, sex, male, female. Census year, 1890, sex, male percent, 51.21, sex, female percent, 48.79. Census year, 1880, sex, male percent, 50.88, sex, female percent, 49.12. Census year, 1870, sex, male percent, 50.56, sex, female percent, 49.44. Census year, 1860, sex, male percent, 51.16, sex, female percent, 48.84. Census year, 1850, sex, male percent, 51.04, sex, female percent, 48.96. As a rule, the proportion of males has increased, owing to the increased proportion of the foreign-born, which consists largely of males. In 1890, the proportion of males was greater than ever before, due to the fact that the proportion of the foreign-born was greater than ever before. In the civilized nations of the world, generally a different condition of things prevails, females being usually slightly in excess of males, as is shown in nearly every country of Europe. In the United Kingdom, Germany, Austria, Scandinavia, the Netherlands, and Spain, females are at present in excess. The sexes are distributed over the country in widely varying proportions, as is shown on the map, Plate 10, Figure 2. The states colored red are those in which females are in excess of males. They are all located on the Atlantic border and include most of the states of that part of the country. In the Mississippi Valley, generally males are slightly in excess.